this dust control thing, knowing that I've been here and I said some of the same things that Michael had said, but I have a question. Does the county have one of these big water trucks that, now like for something like Chapin Road, that they could take out there and just soak that stretch that old spray is on and bring that up?
My response to that is we probably do, but I'm going to go back to my firefighter years, okay? And I have not been a firefighter for 20 some years. If you started out, and let's go down into Jefferson and Washington, I think maybe your biggest amount of gravel roads are down in that area. I rather think, but nonetheless, yeah,
not so many anymore.
And you start through there, the amount of water you're going to lay down is not going to go very far, and you're going to have to retreat somewhere and get more water. It would absolutely be not cost efficient, I believe.
Well, I figured it's much too, you know, unless
do we have such a truck? We might. Yeah, we might. It wouldn't take any more than a truck with a big plastic tank on it, some PVC and some nozzles, quite frankly, and a way to turn it on, turn it off. But we're going
to
use more water than I think you think we are.
Well, you know, some of the road places you'll see them with those literally probably what 5,000 gallon or bigger tanks on them, they'll say non-potable water on the side, you know, and they're using them just to put down water to lay dust during construction, that kind of thing. Yeah. I didn't know if Michael had something like that.
I know the truck you're talking about, and I would rather imagine, knowing how big of, I would say the biggest tankers, fire tankers we have in this county, and there's some pretty big ones, probably don't haul over 3,600 gallon. So a semi-tanker would be about 7,000 gallons. So yeah, I just don't know how we would do it. But yeah, it's a good idea.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know that it's anything that needs followed up on specifically, but I just was, like I say, I was talking to a couple of people, and they brought up exactly that same question. Well, why did they spray at the ends? And I said, well, having been at the commissioner's meeting, I know the answer to it, and I told them, and they didn't say any more, but then I got to wondering myself, you know, whether that other could be wet and be on the way.
You know, I can only speak for Don Amber. I can't speak for anybody else. But knowing what I know, if I lived in that area and I was concerned, I'm pretty sure I'd run a garden hose and a sprinkler out. I think I would. Now, people say, well, I'm not going to run my pump, but I'm not going to waste my water. But if I was really concerned, that's exactly what I do. I would sprinkle my own road. So, okay.
If you're not concerned, just
don't
buy a house on a dirt road.
Yeah. Okay. Nothing else. Meeting adjourned.
And I'm gonna.